It has been more than 3 years since George Floyd was murdered by Derek Chauvin just outside of Cup Foods at 38th in Chicago in South Minneapolis. For a year after that murder, the intersection was closed off to traffic, and it became to many a global memorial for Mr. Floyd and for all victims of police violence. But what was true then and remains today is there were and are businesses in that intersection that rely on traffic to get business. Which takes us to a lawsuit we first told you about last night. The owner of Cup Foods is suing the city and the mayor, saying those barriers there for that year and an alleged lack of police officers in the area led them to losing a lot of business and a lot of money. Now, we reached out to the owner of Cup Foods and we didn't hear back, but Cup isn't the only business down there who has some thoughts about the allegations in this lawsuit. And Kent, you heard from some of them?
Yeah, we did, Jana. And even though this lawsuit is largely focused on the first year after George Floyd was murdered and traffic has returned to that corner, they told me there's still a long way to go.
Word of the lawsuit pitting some 38th and Chicago business owners against the city and mayor is as prevalent and divisive as the barricades at the center of it.
This is my life right here.
Dwight Alexander, whose family has owned and operated Smoke in the Pit Barbecue.
Come on!
Just a few doors down from Cup Foods since 2013.
You said spaghetti and greens.
Isn't a part of the suit, but says he's happy to see it.
It should send a message to him. Put some fire up on him. Probably get some answers and get some stuff going on.
According to the complaint, the businesses claim the barriers that blocked the intersection for more than a year impeded access to their property, led to a drastic increase in violent crime, and a drastic loss in rental income and real estate value. While the intersection has since reopened to traffic and crime has improved, those who remain here say there have been few other signs of progress.
It's kind of like they forgot about 38th in Chicago.
King Demetrius Pendleton is an independent journalist who's chronicled a lot of the struggles at this intersection since the murder of George Floyd. And while he's now also based here and believes the city could do more to help, he doesn't think it can be blamed for all of the struggles.
It could be something else as well, right? Because coming to 38th in Chicago can be a trigger to certain people, so they might not want to come over here.
Do you think the city's response hurt this area?
We all have a stake in the matter. If we all put our heads together and came up with some type of solution, we'd be okay. But until then, everybody's pointing a finger at this person, that person. Everybody's gonna keep on just falling by wayside.
In a statement to Care 11, a spokesperson for Mayor Jacob Frey wrote, "We did everything possible to open the street safely amid very tenuous circumstances. When we finally did open the street, the city did so in a planned way where no one was hurt and the area remained safe for residents. The city itself is not commenting on the suit, but has highlighted investments it made in the area in 2021, including $1.5 million in forgivable loans to local businesses.
They have tried to accommodate us some way, somehow, but I know they can do more than what they're doing.
For example, Dwight says Smoke in the Pit did receive one loan for a few thousand dollars, along with some temporary patio seating during the summer. But he says it's the permanent fixes, like better lighting and street improvements,
forces at the bottom,
that are most important.
I got people that can't even want to park up, so you can't. What is this stuff still up here doing? Everywhere else is fixed up.
If you go down on Lake in Hawatha, you can, it's like an oasis over there. But then when you come on 38th in Chicago, it's like, what happened? Like, won't you all pour some of that money into this area as well?
That same city website does indicate help is coming, touting accelerated funding to reconstruct the 38th and Chicago traffic intersection. But Dwight says every day they wait,
it never used to be like that.
Thank you.
Is a struggle for survival.
Frustrating. It's really hard because there's certain things you can't control. No matter what I do, how good my food is, how nice I am.
Appreciate you.
How many people I talk to.
Have a great day.
It's still that roar over this neighborhood that the city has painted.
Now, both of the men I spoke to today did want to emphasize that while business remains tough, public safety is much better than it was when traffic was cut off and law enforcement response was limited. But they said overcoming the perception of danger is still hard, which is why they're desperate to see the city break ground on those improvements that have been promised for so long, Jana.
Yeah, and as you noted, Dwight's family has been at 38th in Chicago for a long time. I've been to his restaurant several times. It is good, but the way that things are structured right now, it is kind of hard to get there. It's hard to figure out where to park, so you have to empathize with the people that have been there for years as well.
Yeah, and I spoke to him last summer around the anniversary on this show, and he said it's like a wave, and he was trying to get people to come back at that point. They're just getting tired of waiting.
That makes sense. Thanks so much, Kent. We appreciate it.